So I do get this question asked a lot, what is my favorite bat? I'm Sharlene Santana. I'm a professor in the biology department and the curator of mammals at the Burke Museum, and I study the diversification of bats. So I'll tell you one of my favorite bats, which is the Honduran white bat. And this is a very tiny bat. It's about the size of a cotton ball, and it's white with a little yellow nose, yellow ears. These bats make tents under the leaves of banana plants. They chew on the veins of the leaves and they roost there with their family. And they feed on these teeny tiny figs. I call them gateway bats because they're so cute that most people will see them. It's like, oh yeah, it is cute. So people are generally surprised by how diverse bats are. There are over 1,400 species of bats, even perhaps more than that, all around the world. And they live pretty much everywhere except for the poles. They're the only mammal that is capable of flight by flapping their wings just like birds do. But the flight of bats is very different from the flight of birds in that their wings are composed of basically a hand where the fingers are connected by membranes. And so the wings of bats are extremely maneuverable. They can do a lot of things that birds can't do. There's a huge range of sizes within bats. You have everything from the bumblebee bat, which is tied for the world's smallest mammal that weighs only a few grams, all the way to the flying foxes that have a wingspan of about 6 feet and can weigh a couple of kilograms.
This one has really big ears too. So
I'm interested in understanding what features of either the bat anatomy or behavior help them become so diverse. One of the main differences that we see is the shape of their skull. For example, species that feed on very hard fruits tend to have a very short face. Species that feed on, say, nectar from flowers tend to have a very long snout to accommodate a long tongue that allows them to get nectar from flowers. Bats are critical for the functioning of ecosystems. Because they have such varied diets, they can serve a lot of different roles within ecosystems. For example, the insect-eating bats will control insect populations. The fruit-eating bats can disperse the seed of the plants that they're feeding on, so they swallow the pulp with the seeds, and then when they fly and defecate, they transport those seeds to other habitat. And then the nectar-eating bats can pollinate flowers, and there are plants that depend on bats for their pollination. Most bats will be out from dusk until dawn, and yeah, it would make sense that people might be more fearful of bats, perhaps because we really can't quite discern what these animals are when we see them at night. We might be a little scared. But one thing I like to do with people is to show them pictures of the faces of bats. Some of those flying foxes, they look like little puppies. They're super cute.